Let's have a look at general settings of the radio. So I'm going to look at the most important fields, and the first one that we see here is radio name. So in here you can put some text, and this text will be displayed when the radio switches on. The maximum length is 16 characters. The next important field here is radio ID, and here you would put a number, and this number would be used for the radio when it makes a call. So if you want to call this radio, you would call radio number 1 in this case. And it is also used in PTTID. So when the user presses the PTT during a group call, this number is transmitted. Coming down to the bottom of the general settings, I have skipped a few fields here which are important, but they're not relevant to what we need to know. There are two fields here, and they both relate to lone worker. There is the lone worker response time and the lone worker reminder time. So you'll see that the lone worker response time is in minutes. So if we enable the lone worker function, the radio will operate as usual for a period, in this case, of 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, the radio will sound an alert. This is the lone worker reminder alert, and this alert will continue, in this case here, for 10 seconds. If the user of the radio fails to respond to this alert by pressing a button or doing something, change the channel or change the volume, then the radio will enter emergency mode. So obviously you may not want to set it for 10 seconds, perhaps 60 seconds is sufficient. So here, if the user fails to respond to this alert within 60 seconds, the radio enters emergency mode.